For this video, it will be a bit of a departure because I'll be showing you a project I already started. I know this project looks like it's completed, but there's still lots to do, and I'll show you all the techniques I use to finish it off. Let's start finishing off this project by addressing this naked windowsill. This fabric frays so nicely, it'll work perfectly for what I have in mind. I'll use this rectangle as a towel, and I frayed the ends by pulling some of the horizontal threads out. Full-size fabric doesn't cooperate in miniature scale, but I have a secret weapon. A friend of mine gave me this beautiful glass bottle to fill with essential oils. I filled it with watered-down PVA glue. I'm using this concoction to help this piece of fabric hold its shape, so it will look like a 1/12 scale towel draped over this windowsill. I'm just smushing it around until it looks right. Then I'll reinforce it with some extra tacky glue. The towel was wet when I added the glue, but it held really well eventually. I'm holding the towel in place while I use my hair dryer. I pulled some threads out to get this fringe look, and now I'm just giving it a quick trim. Okay, let's talk booze. Here are tiny bottles of alcohol. Once I come up with an arrangement, it'll add some nice interest to this little windowsill. If you're impressed by this creative idea, all the credit goes to Jill Castoral, because this was her idea. This was my idea. I made a little mouse hole to add some charm to my piece. Yeah, I'm gonna fix that. In my experience, dry brushing fixes everything, so maybe I can disguise this dark black line I created with a little bit of dry brushing. I want to use a paper towel to get most of the paint off of my brush, so when I brush it over the surface, I'm just hitting the very highest points and adding a highlight. You can see it's already working to disguise that black line I accidentally created. While I'm at it, I'm gonna dry brush my wood windowsill. This would have been easier to do before I glued alcohol down in a towel, but hindsight. This comes with the kit. I used an X-Acto knife to add texture, then I painted it. Now I'm gluing on the base to support it. I couldn't remember if it goes in front of the band or behind the band. It goes in front. Just put some tacky glue on the back and put it in place. Make sure it's sitting on the floor. And it's installed. When I make my egg carton stones, I like to paint them different colors rather than just gray, and then I unify the look with a black wash. I think it looks more realistic. Jill uses wood shavings to add interest and texture to her floors, and I'll be doing the same thing. I just want to take a minute and show you this wine crate kit. This is also by Jill Castoral, and it adds a lot of detail and charm to that space. Here's an up-close look of my egg carton stone floors. This technique is really easy, and I plan to make a video in the future showing how I do this. For now, I'm just sprinkling some sawdust onto some tacky glue I put around the perimeter. This is a great technique I love to use. I have some chalk pastels. I'll be shaving them with my X-Acto knife and using them to add some age and charm to my faux stone floors. I use my X-Acto to mix them all together. Now I'm using a big fluffy brush and just tapping and patting them all over the floor. So this is like reverse cleaning because I'm adding dust. But we're left with a little bit of a problem. We have loose dust on our floor. We're gonna solve that problem with alcohol. After I thoroughly spray all of it with rubbing alcohol, I use my dropper of watered down glue, and I'm setting the chalk pastels in place, and I'm finishing this off with another dusting of chalk pastels. So that will sit on the surface of the glue. Let's get out of the basement and address this empty wine cabinet. I love this component of the kit. It's multiple pieces, it was easy to assemble, and I'll be adding a lot of detail to the stained glass window up above it. But for now, I'm just using some tacky glue to glue in some plastic wine bottles. For a little bit of variety, I decided to paint the cap of this wine bottle silver. Later, I end up adding some more variety and detail to the caps, but for now, I'm just going to fill up my cabinet. This will look great up here at the top of this cabinet. Looks perfect. A little too perfect. A great way to add character and age to a piece is just using a simple black wash. I just painted this on and let it air dry. The hairdryer doesn't work for this application because it'll blow it away. I cleaned up my messy glue and it looks great. I poked some holes in my plain cabinet doors and now I'm gonna search through my bead drawer for some knobs. I used a push pin to make the holes a little bit deeper, and I used a small hammer to tap them in place, but you could use a different tool if you don't have a tiny hammer. This faux stained glass that comes with the kit is printed on thin plastic. When I glued it in, I wasn't careful enough and it had ripples, so I just removed it, and I'll be doing a tidier job this second time around. Made sure to press it flat and reinforced it with some masking tape. The creator of this kit, Jill Castoral, has a clever idea how to add realism and dimension to the window, so I'm digging through my bag of seed beads and I'll be using these as grapes on our stained glass window. I started out laying the beads so their hole is facing outward, and then I realized that looks a lot like a seed bead lying on its side. So I took my toothpick and flipped them over so just their edges would be showing. And I think that's a much better look. Here's the product that will really bring this window to life. It's called Dimensional Magic by Mod Podge. We'll be using gloss Mod Podge as well, but the dimensional stuff is really the star of the moment. It comes in a bottle and you squeeze it on and it makes this sort of puffy paint effect. But then it dries clear like a resin. I'm just using a straight pin to pull the dimensional magic onto my little leaf sections, and then I used a bit more to unify my glued on glass beads. And then I took my tweezers and pulled out a stray hair, and this is how it looks before it dries. Here it is all dry. I used stippled gloss Mod Podge on the background. Back to the basement. I think this looks a bit empty, so my intention is to take this wooden barrel and glue this tiny piece of fabric to it as another draped towel. I kind of like this more than the towel I chose for the window upstairs, but I didn't know I had this fabric until just now, so it will be my basement towel. There are many times in crafting when you do something and you realize you need to undo it. I realized that barrel looked way too perfect, so I put my little rubber fingertip safety things on, got my X-Acto knife, and started hacking away at this barrel. I own this big file thing, and I started gouging at it with this. There's really no right or wrong way to age something, so just go for it. I pulled out a trio of brown paints. My technique for painting this barrel was just literally slapping the paint on, and then I took a damp paper towel and wiped most of it off. It ended up in the wood grain of the barrel, and it looks good and aged. I love this product. This is aluminum foil with an adhesive backing, so it's aluminum tape. I actually plan to make an entire video about how you can use this stuff to make stainless steel looking items for Dollhouse Miniatures. But for now, I'm just using it to add some variety and texture to some of my bottles. I dry brushed the barrel with some white, finished it off by topping it with a wine glass filled with resin. I used India ink to dye the UV resin. Here you can see some of the caps that I added aluminum tape to. For other caps, I just painted them different colors to add some variety. I love the scale of these little wine glasses made by Chris and Bomb. They're made from plastic, but they look great. Off camera, I made some miniature food. It's really best to use translucent clay when you make grapes, but I didn't have any. Have you ever seen wine that looks like this? Well, now you have. Now all I have to do is call on my excellent painting skills to get the outside of this box painted. I followed up with a dry brushing using a makeup brush. I didn't clean the makeup brush enough, and there are tiny pieces of glitter on this wine room box, so maybe use a new brush. I used a nail file to make this look a bit more rustic.